The city of Vadodara is a bright shining star on the horizon of development. Most important project under Smart City Mission, City Command and Control Center, which is providing immediate and effective services and ensures safety and security of the citizens, has been developed in the center of Vadodara city. It helps in being connected to multiple systems in a single integrated platform like CCTV cameras, smart traffic management, environmental sensors, emergency call box, public address system, solid waste management, city bus monitoring, disaster management. Thanks to the command and control center, we are able to carry out city operations quickly and more efficiently. The city command and control center was inaugurated on 22nd October 2017 by our Honorable Prime Minister Shri Narendra Modi. A noteworthy fact about the CCC project is that this project was commissioned in record time of 7 months, including building construction. The other project of Smart City, City Wi-Fi, is in PPP model, and in this project, fiber network and intelligent poles are also a part of CCC project to save project cost. With CCC, other projects like GIS, ERP, Water SCADA, ITMS, My Vadodara mobile app, encroachment management have been made live, which is helping the safety and security of the citizens. And also, the citizens are proud to be digitally empowered and are happy to be a part of this digital governance journey. Vadodara has got a distinction of being known as the cultural capital of Gujarat. Baroda, now Vadodara, the erstwhile princely state, had a long tryst with history that can be traced back to the first century to the present vibrant Vadodara. The majesty and grandeur of this city of monumental charm has attracted all alike. Vadodara, the testimony of exuberance, the priceless legacy of the great visionary Sir Sayajirao Gaikwad III, has been a favorite of historians, architects, builders and tourists. The unmatched beauty of its palaces, temples, museums, stepwells, statues and buildings is not only an architectural feast but also gives an insight into the vision of the rulers of the city. The old city of Vadodara is crowded and extremely busy. This square fortified walled city with four gates in four directions, Laharipura Gate, Champaner Gate, Gendi Gate, Pani Gate and the imposing Mandvi at the center, the city's vortex, was originally called Qila-e-Daulatabad. It is believed to have been built by Khalil Khan, son and successor of Mahmud Begada of Champaner. Considering the need for significant efforts to upkeep the great historical gates, we undertook and commissioned the task of rejuvenation of the four gates and the Mandvi Pavilion in consultation with experts, professionals, historians and locals. We have recently completed restoration of all the gates and Mandvi Pavilion. To promote tourism, a local heritage sightseeing tourist bus has been introduced. This attempt provides a fair opportunity to boost economy and generate employment locally. In an attempt to appreciate the talent, the local artists were given scrap of various departments and were asked to use their creativity. This resulted into wonderful creations in the form of sculptures. These sculptures beautify various islands of the city and have proved that the city has potential to showcase Vadodara's art and culture. All in all, we are sure that a well-organized restoration and conservation work to bring back the past glory will sensitize the local communities towards the historical value. As a part of rapid development, commissioned the ultra-modern technique of providing potable water, the elixir of life, to the city dwellers of Vadodara. The municipal corporation procures approximately 500 million liters of water from different sources such as French wells of the river Mahisagar, Sayaji Sarovar and Khanpur water treatment plant. After procurement through feeder line, water is distributed to the citizens through pipelines from various distribution centers. In the earlier days, in the absence of modern technology, it took a long time to repair leakage of the feeder line and to restart uninterrupted flow of water. With a view to overcoming these problems, the Municipal Corporation of Vadodara has recently prepared SCADA-based water management project at a cost of Rs. 27 crores. The Gujarat Info Petrol Limited, a government-appointed company, has extended expert advice in the matter. As a part of this project, 76 electromagnetic flow meters, 80 butterfly valves and 108 pressure transmitters have been installed on the feeder line. The most modern technology would enable to provide real-time information of the water level of overhead tanks and would also inform about the chlorine level in the water through city command and control station. Introduction of this technology will enable in central monitoring. The consolidated information will be available on the cell phones of the concerned engineers involved in the project, and this in turn will facilitate precise implementation of the system, and thus waste of water would be controlled. Portable water vending ATM operated on battery cards, that too lithium batteries, is first of its kind in India. A PPP initiative of Smart City Vadodara and its agency DNI Global. Water provided with assurance of best quality and cold to floating population across the city is leading to many positive impacts, such as safe and cold drinking water, portable infrastructure, hence no stress of location and additional power or water support, employment for the youth, handicap and women to man the water ATM. Overall, a positive impact on society and health of citizens in Sanskar Nagari, Vadodara. With the intention of housing for all, Vadodara Municipal Corporation has successfully implemented and executed government affordable housing schemes. Total 58,093 dwelling units are approved under Pradhan Mantri Awas Yojana and various other schemes, among which 38,588 dwelling units are completed and allotted to beneficiaries and 9,535 dwelling units are under progress, whereas 6,460 dwelling units are recently approved and are under tender stage. The aim of ensuring that the land resources are utilized to its utmost capacity and so that every Indian has a concrete home to live in. The idea is to eliminate slums, especially from urban areas, and to provide every Indian a permanent home to call their own and the better standard of living and upliftment of their livelihood.
In the Digital India Initiative, by uniting more than 22 lakh Barodians under one screen, under one application, My Vadodara application, connecting Barodians to the city with probably India's most advanced city-based civic services application, which not only facilitates the citizens to register complaints via traditional routes or forms, but crowdsourcing their issues via GIS technology by simply uploading the image of the complaint, which will allow our advanced technology to automatically geotag it to understand the nature, location and intent of the complaint without burdening the citizens for other details. Emergency services ranging from direct dialing for ambulance, police, fire brigade to a specialized panic button designed for senior citizens to automatically call SOS and notify registered family of the sufferer's location, also covering children emergency and women helpline numbers, empowering citizens to a smarter lifestyle. My Vadodara application, Vadodara's Digital India promise.
Efficient public bus service was a matter of grave concern in the city of Vadodara earlier. The city had just 50 number of buses playing on limited routes, catering service to merely 45,000 passengers daily. On 15th August 2017, under the Smart City Mission, Honorable Chief Minister Shri Vijaybhai Rupani launched a new public bus service system under the PPP model. In a short span of just over 8 months, more than 150 buses, well equipped with LED display, free Wi-Fi, mobile phone charger facility and GPS enabled bus tracking facility have been made functional with zero capital investment by the Municipal Corporation of Vadodara. There has been a considerable increase in the number of passengers who avail the bus services, from 45,000 to 1,20,000 in a period of less than a year. The number of students availing this service has also increased from 25,000 to 70,000. Unlike yesteryears, the bus service has now reached the far-flung corners of the city, covering more areas. An integrated central city bus terminal, Jan Mahal, which is a signature project of Vadodara, the north and south zone bus terminals are also getting ready to cater to the facilities of efficient bus service to the citizens.
Public Wi-Fi project will help citizens of Vadodara to reach, connect and empower people throughout the city to improve education, increase citizen engagement and further bring more opportunities. PPP vendor invest approximately 200 crores Indian rupees or 2 billion Indian rupees in this project. This project do not have any financial burden on corporation or smart city and also get positive premium of rupees 22.41 crores from this project. As part of this project, 450 intelligent poles would be installed at strategic locations across Vadodara. The poles will have fancy aesthetically designed, visually attractive designs including gazebo, fancy LED street lights, etc., which will give it a distinct look. Citizens will get free Wi-Fi for 100 MB or 30 minutes daily. Over and above this, they will get free accessing for government websites. Each pole will have wireless access point and smart billboard. The poles will have provision to install other smart elements such as CCTV camera, environmental sensor, public address system, emergency call box, etc. Smart billboards will display civic and public services related messages such as rain, flood alerts, swine flu alerts, etc. This project public Wi-Fi and intelligent poles on PPP model was inaugurated by Honorable Chief Minister Shri Vijay Bhai Rupani on 14th August 2017.
Vadodara, the smart cultural capital of Gujarat, has been in forefront in adopting location-based services through implementation of a world-class geographical information system. Its highly intuitive spatial and non-spatial data include more than 70 layers of strong geospatial mapping covering every facet of the city, from drainage lines to parks and gardens, from internal road network to gas and pipeline network, all of which captured on a high-resolution satellite images taken over a period of time. This data is relevant, updated, reliable and accurate, with a robust GIS data management framework and a team of GIS engineers working round the clock at Vadodara GIS cell. In order to achieve its end objective of spatial governance, Vadodara has developed an enterprise-wide GIS using open-source technology, keeping guidelines of Government of India in mind and thereby also saving cost. This GIS platform addresses city-level challenges related to enhanced service delivery, accurate planning and informed decision-making by its different unique characteristics like plan, dig and monitor tool, geo-enabled door-to-door property survey, integration with solid waste management and city bus monitoring, geo-tagged complaint management system, innovative initiatives. All of these functionalities and many more spatial analytics as well as geographical queries are integrated with world-class command and control center acting as heart of the city administration and monitoring, and thus truly making Vadodara a geospatially governed smart city.